Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm about to present to you 2008 Volkswagen Passat B6 generation. In this video I'm going to show you the interior as well as take a start of this car. And so guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine. Put on for a while. Aftermarket alarm, aftermarket start, very convenient. Lock and lock, control button. And to roll down all the windows simultaneously, you need to hold the in lock button, like so. And to roll them up together, you need to press and hold lock button. Simple as that. This car doesn't have power moonroof. Like so, very easy. Black exterior, as you can see. Very solid doors, wide opening. Excellent sound isolation indeed. Alcantara inserts. Leather seats, as you can see. High quality leather. Seat high. Recline power, four-way power lumbar, a sliding manual, as you can see, side bolsters, adjustable headrests, belts, of course, three-spoke design, fully wrapped, multifunctional steering wheel, very nicely designed. Everything is very nice put together here, as you can see. Alrighty, let's hop on in. With my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out for me. Not bad. German quality stereo system, dual zone fully automatic climate control. Notice that engine, insert the key and then pressing it. Very simple. Volkswagen information system, as you can see. Service now, already outside temperature 18 degrees. Let's see. Number plate light not working. Front left dip beam not working. Alright. What else? Front right dip beam not working. I believe it's a auto cornering function and range. Manual tilt and telescopic attach, just to use this thing right here. This car comes equipped with hydraulic assisted power steering. Very loud horn, not bad. And of course, this Volkswagen Passat B6 does have automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers. Right now, let's turn the headlight. It's broken actually, as you can see. What a shame. But anyway, high beam and hood lights right there. That's it. There's central lock. Electronic parking brake with auto hall function, as you can see. To engage, just pressing it. And to disengage, put your foot on brake. And then press it again. Simple. Park steering mirrors also heated. Left, right, up and down. Very nice. Power window lock. All four windows in this car are fully automatic in both direction, up and down. Back windows are fully tinted, as you can see. Nice. High quality leather pad. Very nice material. Soft touch right here, right there. And of course, hard touch down there. For the aftermarket alarm indicator, windshield wiper, and also for the remote start for the aftermarket alarm. Aftermarket thing. Door lights right now, let's open the hood and take a look. Take a stare at this car. The red touch up in the head is quite easy. believe this compartment is for the umbrella or whatever. Your rain guards. Passat, as you can see. Rear defrosting glass. Third brake light. Dual exhaust pipes. LED inserts. LED taillights. Very bright. This car doesn't have a parking assist.
The heck?
Okay.
Unfortunately, license plate lights doesn't work. Turbo stratified injection, TSI.
Flaps.
Factory 16-inch rims, stress measuring 205-55, knocking tires, front ventilated disc brakes, and solid disc brakes. Absolutely gorgeous. Factory rims.
Tread wear 300, traction A, temperature A. For its price, this car is very nicely equipped indeed. Let me show you underneath, guys. Your LED turns like this, no stereo mirrors. But this car doesn't have
both cars underneath.
Surprising. A VIN number, excellent coefficient of drag, and there is some crack. As you see right there. Xenon ejector,
roll beam, reflect I-beam, halogen.
Some parts are missing, for instance right there. So guys, this car has inline 4, 16 valve, dual head cam, 1.8 liter turbocharged engine, TSI, turbo certified injection. It produces 152 horsepower. 0-6 time is 8.5 seconds. Maximum speed of 220 km per hour. Ground clearance is around 134 mm. The fuel tank is around 70 liters and trunk space is around 565 liters. Of course, premium unleaded fuel recommended. Once again, 152 horsepower and 250 newton meter of torque. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 7.5 liter per 100 kilometer. The car is front wheel drive. Independent McPherson Strut suspension with anti-roll up front and independent Multing suspension out back. It's really comfortable thing. Front ventilated disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes. Of course, different engines are available for this car. 1.4 liter TSI 122 horsepower and 1.6 liter 102 horsepower. Of course, 1.8 liter 152 and 160 horsepower plus diesel 1.9 liter TDI, it produced 105 horsepower. 2 liter diesel, it produced 140 horsepower. And gasoline, 2 liter 150 horsepower, 2 liter 200 horsepower, and 3.2 liter, it produced 250 horsepower. Main rivals for this car is a Citroen C5, maybe Peugeot 607, and of course Opel or Vauxhall Omega. Of course, Mazda 6, Toyota Camry, Skoda Superb, Ford Mondeo, Honda Accord, and Kia Optima, Nissan Tiana, Volvo S80. The B6 generation VW Passat debuted at the Geneva Motor Show in March 2005. It launched in Europe in the summer of 2005 for the 2006 model year. Unlike its predecessor, the B6 Passat no longer shared its platform with the Audi's equivalent model, the Audi A4. Based on a modified version of the MK5 Golf's PQ35 platform, PQ46. The PQ46 platform provided increased torsional rigidity. The transverse engine layout of the four-wheel drive version, marketed as 4Motion, dictated a switch from the Torsen central differential of the B5 to the Haldex traction multi-plate clutch. Actually, the change to the Haldex system also changes the handling closer to a front-wheel drive car. Compared to the Torsen, the Haldex can direct torque more unequally to the front wheels. Fuel stratified injection is used in every petrol engine version of the Passat, ranging from 1.4 liter to 3.6 liter. 3.6 liter VR6 engine as the upgrade with a 6-speed manual transmissions. And of course, automatic transmission is also available with this engine. As of the 2009 model year, the VR6 engine and 4Motion option were no longer available in the United States on the Passat sedan and wagon, but are available on the Passat Comfort Coupe. Exclusive to Europe, Japan, Australia, and New Zealand was a limited edition Passat R36, which featured a 3.6 liter V6 engine. This version of the Passat put out 300 horsepower and featured dual exhaust tips, an aggressive front bonnet, and all-wheel drive system.
Engine runs great, nothing suspicious, and there is some paint imperfection. Barely noticeable. Alrighty guys, so I'm going to show you underneath. Suspension.
Alrighty guys, right now, take a look at the exterior, let's take a look at the interior portion. The most interesting part of this car. Your address located right here. Main speakers, fuel cap release, trunk release, also with illumination. Very deep storage compartment, water holder, storage. Feels very solid. No lights. All season floor mats. Actually, it's a turnkey car. Pad free. Lumbar support, four way. Recline, seat high, sliding, quite comfy seats. Alrighty guys, right now I'm going to show you pedals. Foot illumination and of course OBD. Oh, I get it right there. Storage compartment. Full B driver, very deep for sunglasses. Not bad. Panel dim, half headlights, light controls, rich wood grain, it's all fake of course, it's not good, it's plastic. Hours to adjust, minutes right here. And of course all your power amenities located right there. Guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Thank you. around 4000 RPM on park. Red needles, very nice sound. Odometer information, service, can increase and decrease the volume. For the stock auto, sounds pretty good.
course the telephone controls, favorites, and multifunctional display controls right here. As you can see, range, route, speed, speed warning, travel time, consumption, average and current fuel consumption, convenience, door open close, convenient mode, I believe. Alright, for the driver, all mirror adjustment, both mirrors individually, and back to factory settings, lights and vision, coming home, leaving home. Alright, then same thing for this side, footwell light, comfort indicator, factory settings, time, hours, minutes, daylight saving, and then date, year, month, day, format, winter tires, plus or minus 10 kilometers. Yeah, language. Alright. Let's choose English. Back, units, temperature, Celsius, consumption, miles per gallon, back, factory settings, and display off. That's pretty much it for this convenient display. Light indicator controls, your intermittent wiper controls, as you can see, and even your cruise control settings. To activate, to deactivate, set the speed up to 20 kilometers per hour and up to, I believe, 250. Yep, up to 250 kilometers per hour. Nice. Overall build quality and all the materials are very nice in this car. Legroom is more than enough for me. Headroom is pretty good and shoulder room is okay. Very comfortable car indeed. A lot of adjustment. And see a storage compartment. Also padded, hidden, right there. Stock audio, MP3 compatible. To insert a disc, eject, mix. Menu, setup, for instance, what else do I have here? Treble, bass, fader, balance, mid-range, so on and so forth. Quite easy to use, indeed. Down here, you can find your dual zone fully, automatic climb control. Turn it off. Fan speed, windshield wiper dicer, ready for us. One touch automatic, air conditioning on and off, of course your temperature adjustment, different modes, facing, etc. Passenger airbag off, recycle, auto recycle settings. There we go. And heated seats. Five stage. High, medium, low, and off basically. Quite easy to use and quite easy to adjust. Solid fake aluminum, solid plastic, an ashtray or a garbage tray, power supply or cigarette lighter, depending on what I use it for. Electronic stability program off. Here we go. Nice. And 6-speed automatic transmission. Reverse neutral drive, manual shifting, plus 40 upshift, minus 40 downshift. Sport mode, very smooth. I guess I can say it's silky smooth. Reverse neutral drive, as you can see, 6-speed. Sport, nice. A lot of chrome, shade, cup holders right here, armrest adjustable, different height position, line felt, but there is no auxiliary input for your stereo system, auto dim rear view mirror, reading lights, motion sensors also, I believe. Microphone for the hands-free, and of course your sunglasses search.
some imperfection, crack, vent mirror with illumination, of course, car holder, side curtain airbag, right here, extra hook, sweet. And for this side, same story. As you can see, not bad. Visibility is pretty good. This car is so comfortable. It's just unbelievable and powerful at the same time. It's just what you expect from this VW. Alright, right now I'm gonna roll down all the windows. And let's continue this tour. Fuel cap release. Check back seats, shall we? Power window control is missing. Got heaters, main speakers, storage compartment, soft touch, leather, padded, child safety locks, door lights. Not bad. Three adjustable headrests. Same Alcantara inserts. Lockable, as you can see. 60-40 split axis, child sinkers, and ISOFIX system also is available. Airbag back here, and for this side also. Quite easy to get in and out. Legroom is good enough, high support is pretty good, and shoulder room is okay. Extra cut hack, illumination up top, very soft. Storage pocket for the passenger side, the rear vents, of course, and power socket, center tunnel, and of course, your armrest. Pass through, lockable, very convenient. Storage compartment right here, and even you can find two convenient cup holders. Nice. Here we go. Our back right there, and right there. Even a power sunshade, and some trims are available. Stock audio sounds pretty good. All handles right here. Legroom, headroom, pretty good, and shoulder is okay for me. With my 6'3" stature, I can perfectly fit in here. It's not a problem at all. Alrighty guys, right now let's check our trunk space, shall we? To open the trunk, it's quite easy. Press this VW logo. Here we go, that's it. Actually, on a B7 and B8 generation Passat, they also put a camera, hidden camera right there. Quite an unusual place to put a camera, or a camera, in my opinion. Five
5W40, coolant, grocery back hooks, cargo downs, as you can see right there, and illumination, trunk illumination,
warning triangle, right here, handle convenient, right there, awesome.
Is the access for this lock, and down there you can find your spare tire, tools and jack. 215-55, 16-inch.
Extra all-season floor mat. Very heavy trunklet indeed. Feels very solid. Fuel cap, horse tire pressure, you can put 17-inch rims and even 18-inch rims, 235-40. I believe it's an ashtray or hidden storage compartment, but it's broken. As you can see, not working. Door cards are perfect shape. You can find manual adjustment for the passenger side. Incline, lumbar support, seat high, and of course sliding right there. No lights. Glove box is lockable, as you can see. It's damped, added with illumination for your manuals. And of course all your service history right there. I guess you can see it's Carfax certified. Of course, definitely not in our country. Also cooled via air conditioning and gun holder plus your car holder. Very nice. Nothing to complain about in this car. Engine runs smooth, plus silky smooth automatic transmission, audio sounds great, the car is in perfect shape in my opinion. To shut it down, just press on a key, that's it, all you need to do. Very elegant key. Extremely popular car, especially in our country. Fun to drive, reliable, comfortable. It's just what you expect from this VW. Way to go. Way to go. Well guys, hope you enjoy my first in-depth tour. This beautiful 2008 VW Passat V6 generation. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, for subscribing. Truly appreciate it. Take care, guys.